So, this is a story of something that happens to me while I was hitchhiking with my dog out in Northern Cal. I was hitchhiking with another couple and their three dogs. I'm going to refer to them as Stone and his mama because for the life of me, I can't remember her name. We were just coming out of Garvinville. We were doing some trimming work up there and, you know, feeling pretty good about life, had a bunch of green in our pocket and having a damn good time. And we were headed down to the Sequoia National Forest down in SoCal to do some camping. And we were coming just outside of Eureka. We got picked up in a small little town. And there's this guy in like a really nice like silver truck, and it was one of those like two doors with like the extended cab. And seemed like a pretty nice dude when he picked us up. He had like a whole bunch of furniture and stuff in his truck, so we just assumed he was like moving. And he's like, you know, I know I got a lot of stuff in, but I can squeeze you in. And you know, we pile in, and you know, we get our dogs in, and we get our gear in, and get ourselves in, and like, this guy starts chatting us up, and he's like driving down, you know, Northern Cal. Everything's like a windy, twisty road, especially, you know, when you get closer to the 101. And like, he's like rolling the joints, he's driving and like chatting us up. We're feeling pretty fucking good about this ride, you know. And it's pretty dark by the time we hit, you know, this little town just north of Mendo. And he's like, well, why don't you guys come stay with us, with me tonight? You know, I can drive you down to Mendo in the morning. We're like, oh yeah, sure, man. You know, why not? You know, thinking we might get a bed, get a shower, why not? And so he starts driving a little ways outside of town. It's like one of those little country roads where there's like the occasional spotlight on the road, like street light. And he pulls up to like this really nice double wide, and like we're kind of excited. And he's like, all right, guys, hold on a minute. You're gonna have to hang out here. I need to talk to my buddy. Now, as he talks to his buddy, there's like this camper, like an old school camper parked in like the backyard of this place. And it's got one of those like property street lights. And he goes up to the front porch and he's like talking to this guy. And this guy's like hanging in the shadows, you know? And at that point, you know, as an intransient, as a hitchhiker, you know, you know when to read things, and we're all kind of sketched out about this. We're like, all right, well, you know, we'll just make sure, you know, somebody calls, you know, their family and let them know where we are. You know, no big deal. It's pretty standard practice for the transients when they get picked up. And so he talks to his buddy. You can't see the guy like at all. Like, he's in, like, lurking in the shadows. So he comes back and he's like, oh, yeah, my buddy's cool with it. Why don't you guys come in? I'll cook us some dinner, you guys can shower and whatnot. And we're like, all right, cool, man. And we get out and we go inside. There is no furniture, none. There's not even a freaking chair in this double wide. No, and you don't kind of think anything of it because he's got a bunch of stuff in the bag. And he's like, well, you know, you guys hang out for a little while. I'm gonna unload my stuff and, you know, I'll make us some dinner. Like, okay, man, no problem. We're like sitting in the living room on the floor, hanging out with our dogs and our pags and smoking some joints and having a good time. And, you know, he's bringing loads of stuff in and out and just kind of putting them in the bedrooms, in fact. We didn't think anything of it. He makes us probably some of the best stir fry I think I have ever had. This stir fry was so freaking good. You know, at this point, he's like talking and just having the the conversation we had with him, like the longer we talked to him, the more and more everybody kind of seemed to be a little bit more reserved and sketched out about the guy. And it wasn't because he was saying creepy things or like weird things. It was just the feeling you got from him. And, you know, we all did the whole call our parents thing. So after dinner, I was like, hey man, you mind if I, you know, call in and check with my parents? So I call my mom, and it's like 10 o'clock out there, so it's like 2 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast, and I'm like, hey mom, I'm in such and such town, you know, if you don't hear from me tomorrow, I need you to call the cops. I mean, it's like nothing no mother ever wants to hear from her hitchhiking daughter. She's like, what is going on? I'm like, mom, calm down, just try to be safe about it. If you don't hear from me by like noon tomorrow, I need you to call this city's cop station. I don't remember the name of the town. And she's like, okay, I can do that. We go back inside, and you know, we have like another joint, drink another beer, and we're like, all right, hey man, we're gonna turn in. And he's like, wait, I want to show you guys my collection. And at this point, we're like, okay. So this is a 3-bedroom trailer. He starts in one room, and he like has clothes and like toys and instruments, things set up in each room, like displayed. You can't touch anything, you can't have anything, but he wants you to see it and know it's there. So at this point, like, all of your basic instincts are going, this is fucking creepy, this is really fucking weird, what is going on? So in the last bedroom, there is all of these family portraits. There must have been like 10 to 15 of them. And there are all these family portraits, and he's not in any of them. Like, we're super freaked out at this point. Why do you have all these family portraits when you're not in any of them? So now, you know, Stone, his mama, and myself are like really fucking freaked out. You know, we're debating whether or not to stay there, and we're trying to be like discreet, being like, should we just bail on this guy? Like, this is super fucking weird. Like, oh my god, what is wrong with this guy? Is he gonna murder us? Like, what the hell is going on? And we're like, he's like, all right, well, let me show you guys to your room. Now, as he shows us to one of the rooms, as we walked in, Stone and his mama were ahead of me with their dogs and packs. And then I walked in last with my dog in here. And as I happen to look down at the door handle, the lock is on the outside of the door handle. Not on the inside like it should be, but on the outside of the fucking door handle. At this point, like, I like grab Stone. I'm like, Stone, look at this. Show the door handle, and like now we're like really freaking out, and like him, me, myself, and his girl like in the back corner farthest from the door, and Stone's like standing there, you know, in between us and the door, and we're like really talking about what the hell we should be doing, because this is super sketchy, you know, this is how like hitchhikers go missing and shit. And he comes into the room and he points at me and he's like, you're coming with me. It's like, oh no man, I'm sorry, I don't roll that way, like I'm not that kind of intransient, like I'm not that kind of hitchhiker. He's like, oh, you're coming with me, and like getting visibly angry. And I was like, no man, I'm not going with you, that's not gonna happen. And he like takes a step towards us, and Stone like shoves him against the wall and just yells, grab your shit. We scooped up packs, dogs, everything, and we're out that front door in 5 fucking seconds. Like, super freaked out. Here we are, 3 entrants again to the middle of nowhere, running down, like, this paved country road, like, freaking out. And all of a sudden, we could hear him hop in his truck and start driving down the road. At this point, I yelled, scram. And everybody jumped off into the woods in opposite directions, just hiding. And I'm like on the side of the road in this like 5-foot ditch in a puddle, holding my dog up against me with his mouth shut as he's driving up and down the road going, I'm gonna fucking kill you, you fucking dirty hippies, you're gonna fucking get what's coming to you. This went on for an hour of him going up and down the road looking for us. So about an hour, we waited probably another 20 minutes and he didn't come back down the road. So at this point, you know, I start yelling for Stone and his mama, and they happen to be just on the other side of the road in the ditch. We come out, we're like, all right, we gotta get somewhere. So we started walking down this road. It was like a 2 mile walk to the end of the road. And right there was like a little seaside motel. So we go inside, we're like, hey, we need to use your phone. We need to call the cops. And like, this poor little old lady is looking at us like, we're gonna murder her. So we're all muddy, we're all wet. Like, you could tell we'd been through some shit. So come to find out, we call the cops, they show up, and they're like, well, you're actually kind of lucky. You know, intransients have been going missing here. We haven't found them. And they showed us like a list of like 30 intransient kids that had gone missing in the area. So at this point, you know, we're trying to help the cops as much as we can, like give them any and all information. And the little old lady ended up putting us up in her little seaside motel for the night and like giving us room to stay and everything. Like, we literally avoided an intransient serial killer, and I've never been able to find anything about them catching the guy. So he could still be out there on the northwest coast, like picking off freaking intransients. He could just be doing it from a different location now. He is like the safe guy that like brings them in, and then the guy in the back that we never saw is probably the one that murders them. Yeah. Oh my god.